Hi everyone, Atul Haziq here from MFA Group. A year ago, my daughter was born prematurely and she was given birth on the 27th week, 7 months into the pregnancy. My wife's water bag burst at 3 a.m. one random night. We rushed to the hospital and found out that she had to be warded. The duration was not specified as well, but doctors said that she might need to stay until she gives birth. My daughter was hospitalized for a total of 2 months. 1 month in the NICU and 1 month in special care nursery. The total bill I incurred was $100,000. We were shocked at the bills and it was a very difficult 2 months for me and my wife. Alhamdulillah, we managed to go through it together and our daughter came home healthy after that. Up till today, I can never forget the experience I had. And I hope no one has to go through the same thing that I did. So guys, here are the 3 things that I learned about unexpected costs during pregnancy. Number one, the monthly checkups during the pregnancy itself. The regular checks may cost quite a bit depending on which hospital you choose. So do weigh your options to which platform suits your budget most. Number two, pregnancy complications can happen to anyone. We are constantly praying for the best, but we must also be prepared for the worst. Certain complications during pregnancy may result in long hospital stays. Always be ready for this kind of situations. And number three, hospital bills, be it with or without complications, generally giving birth in Singapore are relatively cheap, but we must ensure that the services we engage are within our means. It is advisable to calculate your finances before deciding which hospital to engage. Here are the 3 tips to reduce unexpected costs during pregnancy. Calculate your budget properly before deciding private or government institution for labor. I assure you, it will be time well spent. Number two, be financially prepared to bear all costs such as checkups, ultrasounds, blood tests, and vitamins, etc. for your spouse during pregnancy. And number three, get advice from people who have kids so as to make an informed decision on which way would best suit you. I am sure these people are more than willing to share their experiences with you. I hope with these tips, future parents can make the right financial decisions in order to prevent any setbacks in the area of finance. Thanks for watching. This is Fatul Haziq from MFA Group. Do follow our YouTube, Facebook, and IG account at MFAGSG.